My presentation today is on Wilms' tumor gene vaccine for acute myeloid leukemia. Just a brief overview we're going to be covering today. First of all, what is acute myeloid leukemia? What is the Wilms' tumor gene vaccine? Why that particular target? Some clinical trials, and of course, the future of the vaccine. Briefly, leukemia is cancer of the blood cells in the blood and bone marrow. Acute myeloid leukemia arises from a particular type of blood cell called a myeloblast. This immature shell begins to divide rapidly, crowding the bone marrow and causing cancer. Some symptoms and consequences of this are bleeding and bruising easily. The patient also has an affected immune system, so they have reoccurring infections and diseases. They also have a high likelihood of developing what's called an autoimmune disease. Most seriously, the patient can also die. In 75% of cases of acute myeloid leukemia, the patient does actually die. A major cause of this is the fact that there's only one approved treatment, chemotherapy. Since this type of cancer is in the blood, there's nothing you can operate, and there's no target for radiation therapies. This means that there's a great need for new treatments for such a deadly disease. The Wilms tumor gene vaccine uses what's called Wilms tumor gene as a target for a vaccine. This gene gives rise to a protein that's known as a tumor-associated antigen. The sort of protein is overexpressed or at much higher levels in tumor cells or cancer cells than it is in a normal adult cell. Particularly, this protein is involved in the urinary tract development in a fetus, which explains why it's not normal to have it in our cells. The vaccine is produced by taking tumor or cancer cells from the patient. These are then cultivated and the protein is harvested. This protein is then added into the vaccine with what's called an adjuvant, which is simply another compound added to vaccines to stimulate an immune response in the patient. This vaccine is then injected into the patient, where it stimulates the patient's healthy white blood cells to be able to target and recognize the cancerous cells, killing them and leaving the rest of the body unaffected. Wilms' tumor gene specifically has a number of advantages and disadvantages. First, it's highly specific. Since it's exclusive, almost exclusive, to cancer cells and not adult cells, it means you're only going to be targeting the cancer cells and not normal adult tissue. You also have very low toxicity or low side effects, which means that the patient being treated with this shouldn't feel any other effects. Some disadvantages is that the vaccine has to be made specifically for each person. Unfortunately, you can't make one vaccine and treat everyone. Secondly, it doesn't produce permanent immunity. Unfortunately, it seems to be only effective for about 120 to 200 days. After that period, the vaccine appears to lose its effect. The great thing about Wilms' tumor gene is that these advantages are specific to it, whereas the disadvantages are held in common with all tumor-associated antigens. This makes it the ideal target for a vaccine trial. The first trial was held in 2003. It had a total of one patient who was treated with the vaccine. They saw a full remission of their cancer, and today they haven't had any reoccurrences. This was, of course, of great promise. Scientists thought they may have a miracle cure for acute myeloid leukemia. The next major trial took place in 2009. It had a total of 17 patients. However, they found that it was only effective in 44% of the patients. Of these 44%, only one patient was completely cured. The other only saw a reduction for a total of 120 to 200 days. The next major trial occurred in 2014. They saw a much higher response rate at 87%. However, they saw the same pattern that after about 16 months, the vaccine was no longer effective. They also discovered that this is because there's a lack of memory response, means your body won't recognize the cancer when it comes back. The future of the vaccine is a little uncertain. They need to find out how to overcome the lack of a memory response for it to be a standalone cure. However, in and of itself, it still can be viable in combination with chemotherapy. Since there's only one viable treatment, any other options help survival rates and can save lives. The vaccine may not yet be a standalone cure, but it's on its way. And within hopefully 5 years, we should be able to see it saving lives.